one of only two skitters left in existence in the world, and is believed to be the biggest skitter that was ever built. Then over on the left, sitting on the flat cars, is a diesel log loader, which is originally steam operated. Both of these machines work tractoring the log and aim to harvest timber and load the train with logs. But the reason why I'm pointing these machines out now is because here in a little bit, when we get further up the mountain today, I'm going to be explaining to you how those machines work factoring the log and aim to harvest timber. And if you look across the field here to your right, you'll see a mountain in the distance with three peaks. And the peak furthest to the right is Bull Knob. That Spruce was originally a town simply named Spruce. But Spruce was only here for a short 2 years until the town outgrew itself and there was no more room left to develop. So they picked the town up and they moved it a mile and a half down the tracks where they rebuilt the town, naming it a new town Spruce. It renamed the old town Old Spruce accordingly. This is what the old timers referred to as the top of the mountain. And believe it or not, it was even a post office here at one time. And if you look at the forest here to your left in just a moment, you'll see two picnic tables. So we'll use that steam siphon to create a vacuum and draw the water out of the water tank down beneath the tracks up into the water tender on the locomotive. So we'll be here for about 10 minutes while we take on water. So if you need to use the restroom and you don't think you can wait till Bull Knob, which will be another 45 minutes from now while we're stopped getting water, is your best opportunity to use the restroom on the Western Maryland Railroad, which is what the Cheat Mountains Elevator Train from Elkin travels on today. Also, you can see the Shaver's Fork and the Cheat River and a few concrete buildings found in